Cutting Edge on Iriefm with you on next Wednesday. Special Wednesday. Special Wednesday in more ways than one, because this is the first time we are going to transmit this program from our next studio. Them call it Studio B. I don't know where the B stand for. Beloved. All right, cracker shout out as a beloved, but it is looking very nice in here. We have a lot of people for thank. So I hope the producer can give me a list and name, because I don't know the people them more than my immediate people them right here. So we give thanks for this moment in time. And it's long overdue. And finally, we get it done. As you hear the advertisement say in the promo them, we have Lady Marcia Griffiths in the house. Marcia Griffiths, OD. I don't know if it's overdose, but it's some OD.
Oh dear.
Oh dear. All right. Oh dear. Marcia Griffiths is in the house, and if you don't know by now, she's celebrating 50 years as a woman. 50 years in the music business is a very long time, that, you know.
Eh? Long journey.
50 years.
50 years.
I mean, you can't remember the first thing when you do when you come to the music business.
Well, how could I forget that?
Oh, you don't see?
Never. That never leave my mind. You know, I walked on stage the first time Easter Monday morning.
Where?
At Carib Theatre with Baron.
Okay, when the stage show them there.
Yes, right. That's. Everybody, you know, look forward to that show Easter Monday with Baron Lee and the Dragonaires.
Yeah.
Blues Busters was the person.
The big singer them.
Yeah, and Philip James, who is affectionately
from
called Bossy, he insists that I go on the show, but Baron refused to have me on it.
So how old you was at that time?
I was 13.
That's why I'm saying up with the planetar.
No, he said his show was already planned.
Okay.
And him can't accommodate anybody else.
Okay. And is Philip can't drive up on the stage?
No, him insists, you know, and I went to the rehearsal and the band didn't want to rehearse me. And I did Carla Thomas, No Time to Lose. And Muta, you see the morning I walk on the stage here?
Yeah.
I was like 99 pounds away, one skinny little toothpick. And when I stood up out there, you know, waiting for the guitarist to, start the song, No Time to Lose, because the guitar started. Oh, no, I can't hear nothing, you know. You mustn't look around on the musicians, you know, look back. So when I look back on them, I see everybody laughing. And then the audience started to get a little uneasy. And I realized that them plan to just mess
sabotage
up his plane. And even at that tender age, I know that God was with me. Because I just hear a voice, a little girl, you better start singing out by yourself.
A cappella.
And when I start to sing, them better follow me. And believe me, that was it. If you drop a pin. Those days when you emulate a female singer that you love and admire, you tried to dot every I and cross every T. So I was singing the melody and I was harmonizing myself. I was doing everything. So every time I make a slur and a turn, the audience just went up in, you know.
That time the place it pack up.
Oh, Lord.
It was a Christmas show.
Easter Monday.
Yeah. Because we also got it, Easter Monday, Christmas Eve. Everybody go at them show there, you know.
War Theatre and Carib Theatre. Yeah, those are the two places.
Yeah. So at 13, you start singing. I mean, you bust out on the stage.
Well, the rest was history. That was my first.
And now you're gone. You're now 53 year old and you still are singing. No, not serious at all. If you sing so long, it's a serious thing. Believe you me, if you really sing so long, it's a serious thing. Because I know, say, not everybody make it. The journey where you do or where you come to, it's not everybody take that journey there.
And no, and of course, I've seen so many people fall by the wayside.
Mm.
I mean, some of my colleagues, you know, because it's not an easy road, especially a female in a male-dominated business then.
Yeah.
You know, like, no, it's different.
Different, but
coming up in my time, it was never easy.
And you're still there. You transcend the different genre of music. Them, we always say, it's the only female artist that leave from Rocksteady, go to reggae, to dancehall. And you do, what I'm call it, combination with Almia.
Yeah. It's what don't or I never did a combination with.
Yeah. And I can make special reference to the Waliers. I think the Waliers is the group where I've covered them tunes more than any other group. In other words, them sing a tune in a sky era and then come back home singing at the rock.
Yes.
And then come back home singing at the reggae.
Yeah.
And I notice you do it though. I mean,
some of the good tracks that you think, you know, wasn't given certain justice, you just try to cover it, you know, to put more in it.
So why you don't like that version of the other tune? Tell me, how do you sing it? She tell me sneaky, she said she don't like that version of the other tune that she sing it.
No,
so tell me.
In this particular song, most of the studio one songs, I prefer the original.
The studio ones. No, yes. we know, but we just play it. This is
I don't think anything else can top the studio one versions of all them songs.
I agree with you. I agree with you. Okay, so we're going to take the journey from now until 2 o'clock. I hope you can. You drink your coffee.
I'm ready.
And we have all sorts of things that go on here. I tell you, them show me one cake outside. They say, me, I wonder how much people are going to eat that the cake there. And the biggest cake, remember, say.
You serious?
Oh, gosh, man, the cake big like big.
Well,
leave you be.
Oh my! All right.
The reason why we are playing that tune, all right. We know it's your Iriefm Mutabaruka. We know it's your Iriefm Mutabaruka. But here we know we are explore Marcia Griffiths. Marcia Griffiths said the first time she go up on stage at Carib, when them try sabotage her, she sing that tune a cappella, and that start the journey for her. So why you listen to the tune where the original version of the tune where Boss Marcia Griffiths?
When I was going to be 13 in November, my birthday.
And Sunday your birthday. I hope people don't remember. I said Sunday your birthday.
It's two days I celebrate, the 22nd and the 23rd.
What is the 22nd? That's the day when you go up on the stage.
No, man. Well, my birth certificate said the 22nd.
I guess
but
I would.
But my parents tell me it's the 23rd, so okay. I usually.
It looks like you don't get trouble if you come out. Them start come out for the 22nd, like you really come out push out the 23rd.
2 days is an exception, truly.
All right, you start in a studio one. That's where you start. The
you know, I was taken from Carib Theatre that very day straight to studio one.
Eh?
Yes. And
at 13.
Believe me, my father was with me, of course.
Yeah.
And when I walked in there, I met Mr. Dodd, Scratch, all the Waliers. Bonnie and I went way back from kindergarten.
Mm.
So he was the only person that I didn't know.
No, from them time.
And Ken Boo, Delroy, I mean, all these great entertainers, I meet them right there. And I went straight in the studio, no audition, nothing. I recorded.
Record that tune.
Yes.
Come to me, where we go?
The first song is a guy named Newton, who was living in the same year that I was living.
Yeah.
And he write the song, and he said to me, me and him outside here for going in, and he said, hey, Linnet, I'm going to go in there, the nervous thing. And I said, no, man, I'm ready. And believe it or not, him going there and him get nervous. So Jackie, me too, said to me, say, little girl, you know the song? So I said, yes.
Mm.
So him said, sing it. So me end up singing the song all by myself that Newton get away and want beat me up and all them things. But yeah, but
at 13.
Him get away and say his theme song and is him write it and I used to harmonize him. Yeah. That's how I started singing. Anytime I hear a song playing on the radio, I'd find harmony for it. So that's how the whole thing started with me and Newton.
So,
the it's a song with harmony from beginning to end, but this is how it goes. The very first time you walked into my life, you told me that you wanted me to be your wife. Now, after years and years of search, you wanna leave me here with a broken heart tonight. But please don't go, 'cause I love you so. You can't leave me, baby, you're Mr. Everything.
Why me never know say things so much about me? Why you look at me like, wow. Yes, this is the cutting edge of Iriefm every day. I'm with you. I take a break and I'll go back. Come forward to Marcia Griffiths. Break up. Hey, the Marcia Griffiths. Hey, Marcia, I hope you get some royalties for them. Hey, you know what I'm saying? You say that tune, yeah? And truly. And tell me now, every party, I'm not afraid to say it too, but it's a Marcia Griffiths and Dennis Brown play in a party more than Bob Marley. May I tell you that? So, I don't know how you set up your royalty thing, but you're supposed to have a rich woman.
Well,
amount of time. Almia, there's not 1 week I don't play out and not have to play two of them. Three. Same time I play it, it's the woman, they might come and I go so.
Eh?
Yeah, they might tell me if you play it, start it again. So, when you see them, I go so, you don't say if you start it, you would again, you know.
Well, the only thing I enjoy from these songs is just listening to them.
That's funny. Tell me how that go though. Because I'm big tune them.
I don't see no royalties from them.
So you never sign up, ask your BMI, I don't like that. Man, like Al Jeremy, well, not sure you with it though.
Well, just recently, I was advised, I mean, for what you just mentioned, yeah. But in terms of like a producer,
yeah,
for peer artist royalty, I have never seen that ever.
So all them it sang the way upon that studio one album, you know, where you say Bob and the Ride, some of them and yeah, them there. You're not getting nothing for them through
there? Nothing. Never seen a dollar.
Are you serious? So it's a local thing you had to work?
Boy, that's
odd. But you know, sit down, they look like you have chicken go there for your rest of your life.
Right. Look, listen to this. If it's just a shows, it's shows.
Yeah, that means say, yeah, if you go to the show, then you're not sitting there, yeah, I watch
but
TV the whole
time.
But when
you talk about royalty, like producer paying royalty,
man, terrible.
No.
So wait, you know, come, make me get it straight now. Yeah, tell me, say, that studio one album there, we produce so much it after it after it. Marcia Griffiths said she not get no money for them tune there.
No, sir. All the years we've been there.
Yeah.
But I hear Richard talking to you now.
Yeah.
All we ever get when we is like a 9-to-5 job and you're clocking from 9 in the morning and you're there all day, you go in and you sing and you get one Bruce's patty. And it's a lunch that. And that is it. That keep you for the whole day going and just sing.
So you're not going to cats. You don't go to cats and say,
oh, gosh.
Well, I'm bridging, well, I want a party with them, I want a drink to the party, you know.
Everybody was so afraid. Nobody know what, you know, the few people them that going and ask them money. Why? I don't want to tell you it end up.
No, but.
But you know, those days, you know, we just want to go in and express yourself.
Yeah.
We just love it.
Yeah.
And that is why I believe today that this music will live forever because we were doing
it for money.
No, we never think about money. It was from our hearts. We love it. And it's just family fear. Because if Ken would doing a song, we would go in and
harmonize.
Ken would come and harmonize my songs or Bob and they or whoever. You know, it's just a family affair.
But now, in your age, you know, you would have loved it. The money
I would have loved it. If it was piling up, I could have get it
now. Yeah.
I'd have just fly when I feel like and sing when I feel like.
All right, so Studio One hits, and then now you have you move label from Studio One. Why you shift label? Are you never it wasn't your choice, or you don't decide to go somewhere else?
RJ came to Studio one day to invite us down to his studio. Up to Studio One, and Mr. Dad see him out there and race him from the gate.
Yeah?
Yes, because him figure say, you know, RJ come for
take away my artist there.
And we ended up at RJ because nothing was happening at Studio One. As I say, it's just a party and no pay, stage show, no money, no royalty. So we went to RJ, and that's where we
start.
Did Young, Gated, and Black.
Yeah, the big hit.
Yes.
That propelled Marcia Griffiths and Baba and the internationally,
yeah.
Nina Simone tune. That's sweet, you know. That's sweet. And I realized that after that tune there, that beat itself take all in England. I don't know if it did already and then just do something, but
no,
the first time I
knew
about that beat there,
yeah,
is that tune there. And then all of a sudden now we hear a whole heap of tune of that beat there in England.
That was the first one with that beat. And you know, it's funny, our audience was some white skinhead,
yeah, racist like youth them, yeah. Almost most of them from England, yeah. I remember we go cross in a Berlin. We are on Copeland going to Berlin. Not Berlin, East Germany. Go perform. And a pure skinhead there. They attack. Yeah. Well, Hitler. You know what I mean? I said, wait, we'll be there. You know, we're frightened because, you know, them ears stiff up, guy like them.
Yeah.
Put starch in them ear.
Hippies.
Woolly but chain and all them things. Yeah. And at them, them with Derek Mark and Prince Buster and all them things. So, that tune then, oh, you must make some money off of that one there.
No, that was worse. Cause listen to this. Bob Andy will endorse it. He's, you know, find out from Bob Andy.
Mm.
We were young and naive, and Bob Andy was really exposed to publishing and all that. But at the time, I remember, you know, it's just performance again, as I said earlier.
Yeah, yeah.
No royalty.
Mm.
I remember after we come back from England, and this was the biggest thing happening in England and Europe.
Yeah.
No money unless we go and do some live shows in England, tour in England. And I remember we come back and we see a Chris Benz park up in the RJ studio.
You remember the Benz one?
Yes, and a brother said to Baba, and he said, Baba, and you're your Benz. And him say, I'm my money back, but I don't know me want it.
No. When you hear them story, you realize, sweet the music should be. Because of the suffering and where the artists they've got through.
It's the love.
Yeah.
The love. And you know that this is your portion in this life, and God bless you with that talent, and you just want to, you know,
manifest it.
And just send a message to the world and teach and educate and uplift people.
Yeah.
So, you know, it makes you happy when you see people happy. So it's just that keep me, my fans keep me throughout the years.
Yeah. I cannot visualize all my help. I know I drive to my work in a Mercedes Benz. I mean, I ride bicycle. You know, it's like a terrible thing that. But Arigia seem to have some big hits internationally, like Telephone Love. No, Arigia.
Liquidator.
Yeah, Liquidator. Yeah. All them songs that they did for Arigia label. And I remember that. I don't know if it's him that produced it, but I don't know if it's Pleasure Hannah for either the studio. RJ Studio, when Bob Marley did a record, Revolution.
Yes.
That tune there,
quite
you know?
A few of Bob's songs was recorded.
Recorded inside it, so. All right. Make we come to a brethren where him play a great part in my life and me create a great part in your life. Because the first man came me got a studio. And wonder who we attack.
Yeah.
He must know who we attack. But I will tell we attack.
Oh.
The first man came me got a studio. And it was the biggest thing by radio at the time.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Tell me about that connection there.
You know, it's that connection as simple as a seat. I am still in astonishment because I had no doubt that this was my soulmate.
Mm-hmm.
And he was sent truly from... Everything was just so perfect.
Mm.
And I'm still wondering how... This man was sent and was taken away, you know.
Just like that.
Yes, just like that. Because I met him in the, 70 when we came back from England.
Mm.
And the story that Errol tell me, it just add up to for me to know, so well, this is ordained. Yeah. This is not a coincidence that I met this man. And because I'm saying, I must play the same song in Washington that I was just singing here.
Mm-hmm.
And him say, when him listen to the voice, him say, something in them head say, suppose if I get this girl, man, one day. And that's how it ended up.
Yeah, E.T. from D.C.
Yeah. Mm. I mean, it was the hottest thing.
Yeah, it was.
On radio.
You remember how him, I mean, them say police killing by Washington Boulevard. You remember how that go?
I never hear... The true story of that up until this day.
You ever hear say that though? You ever hear say police kill him?
Well, I know that he was detained by police that night.
Mm.
And when we tried to inquire, them say, you know, them don't know of it. And then when we went up to this station somewhere near Duane Park there.
Yeah, man, up at Washington Boulevard. Yeah.
They eventually said that he was detained the night, but I don't know the true story about that.
And nobody never got to the top of it to find out what really happened to this great, this Jack
to this
radio.
Day.
But I
just know that he suffered,
and,
you know, it was brutal.
Yeah.
Brutal.
Well, in history, go down says police kill him. I don't know. But in history, historically, when people talk about Errol Thompson, them say, oh, a police killer bridge in there, you know? Yeah, man, people say that. But him dead was something else for radio, too, because radio...
I never realized how loved he was to other radio personalities until he passed, and I hear so many radio personalities try to sound like Errol.
Then
I realized that he was really and truly admired.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he was blessed with that voice.
Yeah. Mm. All right. Studio One, R.J., where next?
After R.J., I think I went to, I recorded Sweet Bitter Love with Lloyd Chalmers at Federal.
Mm-hmm.
ABC Music. His thing was called ABC Music. Mm-hmm.
Sweet Bitter Love, okay.
Yeah, I think, that was before Miss Pottinger in the 70s.
Yeah. So you had hits or just a hit with Lloyd Chalmers?
No, man, I had a couple hits with Lloyd because Sweet Bitter Love was a number one song from the album. And you know what, Muta? Incidentally, I don't know if you remember Buddy Davison. You know him? Buddy Davison wrote a song from the album Sweet Bitter Love for me. Him have a very, very strong voice, and he was considered that time a very good songwriter.
Mm-hmm.
I just saw Buddy in a home in South Florida, a nursing home, and the man was off the... You remember Buddy, though?
I hear the name. I don't remember him so much, but I hear the name.
And then, you know, the thing about it is, Lloyd Chalmers, who know him so well, he's not even around for me to say, Chalmers, you know, he's gone.
About 2 years ago, Lloyd Chalmers did that.
Lloyd Chalmers was a very good producer.
I've
met few producers in my time, because a lot of people, when they use the word producer, them don't realize it's not because the man put up the money.
Yeah, that's the executive producer.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But producer, Lloyd Chalmers, is few of them I know, Bonnie Wheeler, Lloyd Chalmers.
Yeah, them sit with you when you're singing and know
and
when you have
key. Ideas. Them tell you how they want the bass line and what them hear the guitar should play. That is, you know, you have
that's
input
producer, of
in
course.
Producing the thing.
You have some man now say my producer and him send the artist to go voice the tune. And him gone out and in a virgin place, go sit down and say, I laugh, I can kick, king. And then when him come in, him say, all right, you done? All right, next artist. You know, them not really sit down with the artist and define the music. You know,
them believe says just the money make them a producer. Yeah. They are executive producers.
All right, so you move from now, Lloyd Chalmers, Pottinger next.
To Miss Pottinger, the only female producer.
From them time.
Yes.
Yes. Very successful.
She used to do gospel first.
Yeah.
And I remember Judy Mott was recording for her as well, and she changed her name, you know, mm-hmm. because, you know, she was signed to
I hear about that. Yeah.
Miss Pottinger, you know, was a woman that we could relate to as another female.
Mm-hmm.
And I was very comfortable working with Miss P. So was Sister Judy.
Mm-hmm.
And when I went there, I met Errol Brown, EB.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we the first single we did was Dreamland. And I recorded two albums at Miss Pottinger, Step In and Dreamland.
Yeah, stepping a big tune.
Yes. Mm. And everything was just beautiful recording at Miss, especially with Errol, because he used to just put everything.
Great engineer.
Yes. Yeah. And he took pains to do, you know, once we're in the studio, Errol gave his all. So I was really comfortable there. Maybe that's the reason why I had so many hit songs.
With Miss Pottinger.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. All right, so we move now from, we are going through the producer, and then we produce Marcia Griffiths over the years. So we move from Miss Pottinger now, where we go now?
After Miss Pottinger, I think is, we did a couple of tracks with Fattis, Exterminator.
Yeah.
Just a few.
Yeah. Jeremy and
Sydney.
Remember that I said Sydney Crooks, yeah.
You mean Lodi Crook? Lodi Crook. Well, he came in just after Errol passed, when I was really in a down state.
Yeah.
And this man, I started an album with Errol, and Lodi Crook just walking in my state of grief and stress and depression, and just took the album that I started with Errol, add a couple of tracks to it, and just take off with the whole entire album.
Yeah.
And that was the end of that album. Children of Israel was one of the tracks on that album. That song went to number one in New York. Lord, it disappeared, and the last thing I hear is that he was living in Brazil.
Up
until this day, Lordy has never given account to me for nothing.
Yeah, well, there's an awful lot of coffee in Brazil, so we don't know if the coffee them drunk him.
I saw him in Brazil like about 2 years ago.
Yeah.
And it's just beer hard luck story.
Yeah, all right, we're going to take our next break and come forward. You can do it, not do it, watch it live. And then live in colors over here, yellow mark and them crew around it, so you know. Where is the name again? Cuba? Which one is the name Cuba? How are you name over there, so? 80? Where is your name, Virgin? Robbie? Oh, are you name Robbie for last? You have to think about Robbie Virgo. Okay, all right. So we are saying watch it live on irfm.net. And you can see we are going here, so now, right now, they must set up a cake, you know. May I tell you that Kiyekia, believe you me.
Yeah.
Me never know so much.
Why? Even IRFM, good.
Hungry belly, you know,
this could have served for all of my fans, you know.
You know, say.
This could have served for all of my fans, you know.
You know, say, every IRFM person me book up say, them now live till the cake cut.
Yeah.
And you know, say, me never did want to cut it till 2 o'clock. That's when can't go home. Believe you.
Everybody have a sweet tooth, man.
Big. So it must a rollie now, Marcia. Trust me, man. It must a rollie now. Tell me say it a rollie now, please.
From royalties. From
yeah, don't make me sorry for
performance.
Yeah. Tell me say it a rollie
like
now.
Like PRS, PL.
Yeah, it a rollie. Yeah. All right, it a rollie. Man, that's not why you that it a rollie.
But the wallet roll out already, you know, so then the backup. Then the backup in the wallet did roll out already.
Like. All right, we got a Pottinger now, don't it? Pottinger.
Yeah.
Me prefer cut out the 15. How do I cut the cake, Marcia? Tell me.
So?
I left out the Marcia. Don't cut the Marcia. All right. So, all right. All right. See, Jano. I stop Pottinger now. You know. I'm not ready for what takes this picture. World! World, don't look for this, you know, Marcia Griffiths and Mutabaruka and cut the cake. What we do? 1, 2, 3.
Come.
should have asthma, you know, because you stay far up below the whole candle. You know that you should have no asthma. All right. Yes. Let me take up the cake and share it. All right, go on. You don't have to go on like you don't want to go to the picture. Watch out. We don't know your farmer thing right now, so you know. Okay, we don't know farmer thing right now, so. And we don't want you to give them cake and make them choke, you know. You have to get something to drink, though.
Yeah, who wash it down? Sweet.
Yeah. You have something to drink, though, right? Who wash it down? All right. And then you have a good smoke. About the cut-up cake, you know. Even though it might look like no beef inside us, but trust me, see outside, eh? All about the sports department. You want to see the one that everyone come and want a piece of the cake.
There,
yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So, we did really they have Pattinger. I will move from Pattinger and go to this bridge, you know, you said they are. You say him they are Brazil, where you never see again.
Lodi
is after Passenger.
Sydney Crook.
Him is a crook. All right. So, Pattinger, Lodi, then who you say now?
My schoolmate, Bonnie Jabby.
Bonnie Wheeler.
Yes.
Bonnie Wheeler produced now.
An album.
Which album that now?
You remember Margarita, did have a song named?
Yes, yes.
Woman A Come.
Yeah.
That was the first one. Ayata?
Yeah. Jada? Yeah, man. Yeah, man. Yeah. Yes. All right.
So it was an entire album that we'd have before we go into the electric
boogie. Tell me so. All right. Out of the electric boogie and the young gifted and black, which one bigger?
Electrics. Electric. Of course, electric. Yeah. Yeah.
Trust me. You see all that children, you know, when you talk about party, disco, when you look on a dance floor, when that starts, you know, all people, you see, when everybody's supposed to go the same way. Oh. Some people gone all over there, so when they're supposed to go one way. You know.
I tell you, I went to Baltimore when I had the electric slide day.
Mm-hmm.
And I couldn't even sing because I've never seen 100,000 people doing a dance and everybody going one way. Like a wave. Even the policemen on duty, they were doing the electric slide.
You know, sir, it I find it funny when I play that song, they watch people are dance. Some people are going left, some people are going right, some people are going backwards and everything. Everybody are trying to catch up with everybody.
Them
and
don't know it.
The person who are going right, feels him to catch up with the person who are going left. And the person who are going left, feels him to catch up with the person who are right. So when they start going, everybody start go right and left again. Who create that dance? Because it sound like some really... Like it's some right redneck dance.
No, it's right in a Washington, D.C. And that dance outlived the Madison, the Twist, the Bus Stop, every other dance. Yeah. Macarena, all them other dance, it outlived.
A big tune.
Yeah.
Bonuela, right, that tune there.
Yes.
Bonuela.
But, you know, I have to tell you very quickly. You see that song? Out of the weirdest thing and things that happen in life to people on them journey. This was something so significant because I Trees went to Toronto to do a show. No pay. We get $800 Canadian each. And I take my $800 and I walk downtown in Canada, Toronto. And I walk in this tour and see the secret rhythm box. And I decide to just buy the, I just love it. It play every rhythm and every sound, a wire and every beat it have. And I buy the rhythm box, bring it down. And I just fall in love with a piano part in it, the repeater sound. And Bonnie, of course, we always see each other from, as I said, we go way back. And he used to visit me every day, bring nice fresh fruits. And him fall in love with the rhythm box and him just record the beat, just like we hear the electric boogie start, with the repeater piano, took it to Portland. And the next day, Bonnie came back with a song. So everything was just so spontaneous. We never sit on it. And the same kind of vibe that the song was recorded with, then in bringing Sly and Robbie to overdub with the bass and the drum.
And that all started from a rhythm box, so you're buying
that. All the songs on the rhythm box. Every instrument, most of the instrument, the keyboard, is that rhythm box on the electric boogie.
That's a sweet history. One of the biggest. Marcia Griffiths song.
Out of a no pay.
Yeah.
Came a monster hit from a little rhythm box.
And you know you can't do not stage one of that song there.
Oh Lord, I couldn't walk, come off a stage and don't do that
because song. Because it was my sacrifice back to that start show. If you don't do that song there.
No, but I always do it. I always do that song. Every wedding, ship cruise, just about every single place. And right. Starts in kindergarten to the home for the age.
Right. All right, so Bonnie Wheeler now, next producer.
You mean after Bonnie?
Yeah.
After Bonnie, I think is Penthouse.
Clive Hunt. Somebody about
no, Clive Hunt. Hunt was with Miss Pottinger. Yeah.
Clive Hunt was a big producer, you know.
Yeah, he was the arranger.
If you're holding for them song, yeah. At them time there. So he was really the producer, well, he was the executive producer.
He was on all the sessions that I did at Miss Pottinger, producing and him do the horn section and blow the trumpet.
Yeah.
Clive is a very good arranger.
Yeah, of course. All right, so, well, all right, so we're going from Bonneville to where? Where we going from Bonneville to? Yeah. Jermaine?
Penthouse. Yeah, Donovan Jermaine.
See, well, Jeremy, come over here. So, come over here, so Jeremy, because you know what the issue is. You know. Come over here. So. Oh, you're going to have chickpeas, so Rasta. You have chickpeas for you? Sit up over there, sir. Give this man your mic for me, no. Do. Give this man your mic. I don't want to sit up beside her, you know. Sit up over there, so my wait until we put that seat there for Bridget. No, sit up. You're going out of the frame, man. Sit up over there, so. No, sit up over there, so. You know why the place look empty all the while, man. Yeah. Like, so you said Jermaine is the next producer.
Yes.
All right. We could ask now. It's him the after Jermaine. Oh, I stop at Jermaine.
It stopped right at Jermaine.
All right. So that we have.
But
right
then between Jermaine and
yeah, but a little producer around
no,
the corner.
No, little producer, big producer because like Barry Salmon.
Oh, Barry Salmon produced some too.
Yes.
You don't sing with him.
Quite a few songs I've done.
Yeah, you don't sing with him.
No, man.
Like with Julian.
Jermaine produced a couple of songs that we did, like Live On.
Yes, big tune.
Yes. And I do a lot of songs that Barry's write and produce.
Like with song. I mean, I really know. I mean, I know the song, but I don't know the writer.
Barry Salmon himself do quite a few combinations. Some of them never ever released. And
so, he produced them?
Yeah, Barry's producer.
Yeah, Barry's produced them. Barry's producer, a song, Time Alone Will Tell, on the Slim Smith rhythm.
Yes, yes.
If This Love Is Real. Some beautiful song. And another song that Barry's produced was a very old song. If the sun should tumble from the sky. You remember that song?
I have it in the computer.
Yeah. That's a beautiful song. Barry's right. Do a beautiful rendition, you know, producing that song.
You know, say. All right, Jeremy, yes, how you doing, man?
I'm fine, thank you.
Well, you should reach right at the city, you know. That Jermaine should reach, and it come like, to stop at Jermaine.
Yeah.
Big song, them you have. Big song. Tell me now, the relationship, you know, because...
Well, I go and pass artist and producer, though. You
yes, like serious.
Man, no,
you're serious.
With family.
No, wait. The whole land. We're going to a different level, you know. Pass, producer, and thing.
Yeah,
Marcia said, mind where you said, or Jeremy.
Family, right?
He clarified because we go for ready, God, look that busy. I know, you know, because we love this so little more, you know. All right, so tell me now, how you get for produce this lady?
1986. That song name everywhere. So I keep a Jamaica slide on bar. I need to make Marcia Griffiths record this song. So from 1986 until now, we've been doing business.
Yes.
So everywhere, actually the first song we did.
Which one?
Everywhere.
Okay.
Fleetwood Mac. But the original writers for the song. And if you have it, can play it.
Yeah, and?
We continue from there. We did the album Marcia. And then we went into Fire Burning, Closer to You. And then Barry Salmon, Live On.
Yeah, we
had Bujo. There was a string of Bujo hits there with Marcia.
Yeah. We had some nice collaborations at Penthouse with everybody. Yeah, Cutty Ranks, Tony Rebel.
Fire Burning. Mm. But you know why Marcia is such a unique artist in this level, that if you have Marcia and a Bujo combine and make so much hit song, consider and say Marcia has sing before Bujo band. And if you come here, Marcia, and
can you imagine?
I sing it song. It's a unique thing that in the music industry.
It was deliberate, really, you know, because like I said, Marcia was from a previous generation of artists before Bujo and Tony Rebel. So my concept was to really try to tap into each age group. So that's why I put it both.
And you did it perfect, man.
I have to give Jeremy and that.
Yeah, man, you did it perfect. Yeah. You did it real perfect, believe you me. Because when we listen to the Bujo song there with Marcia there, I mean, you can't ask for nothing better than that. And she just gone at night.
The cutterans and the Tony Rebel.
Fire burning. Yeah, you can't believe that. Yes, we're talking to Jeremy now in this period of the music industry, the music business, you know, because Jeremy obviously have made I don't like to say comeback, you know. But I know say maybe a little lull after a period of time. But I see him now fire up again with some young artists, you know, where, you know, I mean,
Well, the problem with that, you know, that so when you have artists and they become established and they want you to go on the road with them, you take away from the studio.
Okay.
So you're on the road with Butcher for all these years.
Yes,
you can't find the time to be creative in the studio.
But you would have to go up on the road with Sugar, you know. Because Sugar look like she's going to blaze up the place.
She's a good artist, man.
So Marcia and Sugar, how that going now? Well, the combination and the combination.
Well, I love Sugar voice.
Oh, she's sweet, man.
Yeah.
Jeremy, really here we are push something at some fire, man. I push it fire, Marcia and Sugar.
Marcia and Sugar can be done.
No, but me and Sugar talk about that already all the time. We talk about that. She will tell you that. We discuss that, man.
Yes, Jeremy was responsible for Bujo Bantan for years. Mm. And then it's got to ranks and the fire burning tune are your tune, don't it?
Tony Rebel took things that's all right.
Yes. Who else did combine? You combine her with in a them time there?
She and Barris and Mikey Spice. She and Wayne won.
Bunny Rugs.
Yes, I mean, we play. It's not funny. It's not funny. Are your tune that too? Yeah.
Who else we did? Marcia.
Your little artist there.
I'm busy signal.
Yeah, busy.
You see where she gone? All busy she gone. So wait there. Eh? Oh, break. All right, I'm going to take the break. Break it.
And all them other liquid stations, what me say? That's straight reggae. You hear that?
Yeah, this is the Cutting Edge Special Edition from Studio B. And it is streaming live for free. And IRFM.net, free all around the world. You can tap into this IRFM.net free. And you will see this great thing that is happening right here in IRFM. All right, now, may I hear some things off here? Yeah, we have blow up media, you know, I blow up here, because me love the little passa more time. As simple as you take it to that. May I hear some passa, you know, where the world have to know. Because me a little them children, I never know them. But first, before we go to the passa thing, you did a mention about doing a tune in German language with the orchestra.
1969, Fab Five and myself with David Banks. He was the person traveling as my guardian.
Yeah.
And we went to Germany, Munich, but they were called then the Reggae's. Because they never named Fab Five yet. And we recorded an entire album and did a couple of shows. Mr. Hoover heard Fab Five playing at Thinking Somewhere one night and myself was singing. Mm-hmm. And he decided to take us over there. And it was my birthday and they flew us to Berlin. And Muta, I walked in the studio and saw this man look so... As you see, me know him as a professor, a musical professor with a pipe. And they played a track. And I sat there just dreaming and said, boy, when I am going to ever be able to sing on a track like this? 30-piece orchestra.
Mm.
And when I listened to this song, The man said to me, say, you like it? I said, I love it. And he said, it's yours. I couldn't believe
it. That was before John was asking you the orchestra. I thought about that.
1969.
Mm-hmm.
And when the man says yours, I said, no. I never believe him. And I had to do it in German language. And they took me next door, taught me the German language, the song.
The
throat is the hardest language. Because the throat thing, you have to get the knock at the throat.
Anytime a German attacks me, I feel old, I feel sideways. I come at any time, I feel fly out of the
way. I think it's the hardest language.
Yes.
And I went next door and them ribbit it. Mm. And I came back over maybe after 2 hours and recorded the song. And
so you studied the language
Of course, I had to tell me what the meaning was.
Of the song, yeah.
So I could emphasize certain word and, you know, express it properly. And
so with that song today, you say you have it by your phone?
Yeah.
But you can't leave it without it. You even flip your phone.
Because no,
you have to find a song there.
It's a 30-piece orchestra with 12 backup vocals.
Mark, you can't take that thing off our phone for her. Where is it? In our internet, in our email,
yeah,
on the phone.
Email, yeah.
No, it we have to get that song there. We have to get that song there, man. Believe
and
me.
And listen to me now, Muta. I remember when I stopped in New York, I went to my sister's house, and coming into a cold place like Germany, I wanted to get a boots, and the boots that I pick up, she said, no, don't take that because something wrong with the leather.
Mm.
The boots, most of them can't tell you the boots stink.
Mm.
And
the animal never dead good.
Boy, I don't know it's what, but I have on the boots. I have on the boots in the studio,
yeah.
And I have on the boots all day. And there's no way I could have taken off my shoes because everybody run. And you see, when I finish voice a song, and them sit down and listen back to the song, the German man drop my boots and kiss my foot bottom and ask Frankie and Grubbs, yes, everybody's here. Them say they never hear
that
nothing like
that. You must use the smell.
What? Look here now. No, but Muta, me tell you, me couldn't believe it. Me just wanted to go through the ground.
Yeah, no, we have to find that song. No, we have to play that song. We have to play that
song. It's two songs I did in German. A love song and this song.
So you remember when the song I say, not in English?
Oh, I'll do anything you say.
You see, Rose?
Make this burning go away.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, I'll never want to be without your love. And the German part is blight by me, which is stay right here.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all about ich tu alles, was du willst, wenn du nur meine Liebe stillst. But as I say, it's a true thing.
Yeah. Is you learned that in 2 hours?
A little more than that.
You're serious?
Yeah.
Wow. All right.
It was an experience though. Beautiful.
All right, the next thing we want to go in is the history behind some of the songs that you do. Because me never know about this history of these songs. So, I'm going to play this song, yeah? And you're going to repeat what you tell me about this song, yeah, right?
So, it's when I leave, I went to Germany. And when I, on my return, he wrote this song.
Babandi.
Yes.
And this song, I talk about
how do you feel when your baby's gone?
Yes, Baba, anyway, believe you me. You know, me a little out of the studio all the while, and I think, say, wait, Baba, me I tell you, the history behind the song, a very serious thing, very, very serious revelation to me, and not a revelation to Jeremy, too. Are you there the 20th years? You can't believe that.
I will hear them.
Yeah, eh?
I was aware.
You was aware of them?
Yeah.
I want them Copeland was aware. Copeland is aware, right? Oh, so I mean in the loop then. Yeah. All right, I mean in the loop. Yeah. Wow, most of the people that want to listen never in the loop. You think I'm going to be one never in the loop? Most of the people that want to listen right now, the time is 12 o'clock, midnight, IRFM.
Brothers and sisters, this is Charlie. Join us with respect for our national anthem. Let us stand and defend this one. Peace and love. Thank you.
Eternal Father, bless our land. Guide us with thy mighty hand. Keep us free from evil powers. Do we through countless times to our leaders, great defenders, grant true wisdom from above. Justice. Truth. Be us forever, Jamaica land we love. Jamaica, Jamaica, Jamaica land we
I have to say about Marcia, because someone singing for 50 years and still relevant to this generation.
But me not tell you, man.
Trust me. But the thing with Marcia, I have a fighter to come to the studio otherwise, today, though. I busted. She would tell me she's coming to the studio today, 10 o'clock.
Yeah.
And it's like 3 days after 7 o'clock to turn
up. But tell you honest, you'll be not afraid if she come here something, you know. Be not afraid, you know. It's when me say a quarter to 10 minutes if she come here and say, all right, hold your peace, I don't vote tomorrow, because this God too much things, I don't make this thing, I don't work out. When the doctor come in and say, oh, Marcia is outside, me I tell you, man. My diary, I go right up back. Me I tell you.
Yeah, but. Yeah. Still, it's been a pleasure working on there for this 28 years, you know. And we still have a lot of material to come on the street soon.
Yeah.
You know?
So you have any tune with that when you don't release yet?
Yes, man.
Then why not release them?
They just released a song with that recently, Beatitude.
You mean the one where I'm listening to sing one time, right. The Bible verse,
yeah? Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, you don't release that yet?
It's just come out now.
No, but you say you have a way for tune when you don't release it.
Yeah, but we can't release all the songs at one time.
No, but not one time. Look how long you do them.
No, but you still be the tune just came out last month.
Last month it come out, yes. They don't been having.
Yeah, man, check your inbox, man.
Yeah.
Make sure we
check
your
it
stuff,
every day,
man.
When Mr. Jeremy, when we see Penthouse, you know, me now ramping up, me start download immediately. Well, you know that, you know.
I got cost the engineer then.
No, I want the only label where as me see Penthouse, you know, me just say, all right, download immediately.
That's good to hear that, man.
Yeah, man, that's true,
man. Try and maintain the quality.
Brian, how are you lining up some of them things there? Play one of them, make me hear it there, Brian. Play one of them. Brian, light it up. You give money. Am I hearing me? I say,
yo, this is Anthony Cruz live and direct, and I just want to wish Sister Marcia Griffiths happy 50th anniversary in the music. Trust me, 50 years, that's not something normal. Trust me, and I wish you also Cruz. Happy birthday. You're done more, Anthony Cruz.
You not have to answer me, not to
more love.
Thanks, Anthony.
Move love the arms, though.
No, be I tell you. Go on, man. Go down the line, Bridget. Go down the line.
For manager and Canadian for Marcia Griffiths. And I would just like to say that congratulations on her celebration of first her Earth Strong, which is her birthday, because you have to have a birthday before you can have another anniversary. And I must say congratulations on the celebration of her 50th anniversary in the music and entertainment business. We grew up together. We went to school together. Her family and my family were very good friends. So we have been coming a very, very long way. And I feel very honored to be a part of this musical journey and to play such a great role in the development of her career and the continuation. And I wish her all the best and hope and wish that she can celebrate another milestone like this and will continue to sing I Shall Sing as long as I live, and I know she means it from her heart.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
that was
thanks.
Copeland Fabs, who's playing God, because I'm depend that over there, so I'm in the studio over here, so it's a kind of multiplicity of personalities taking place here. Okay, we're going down the line now. Here's this junior now, because this junior is a very not only unique, but rare. And you have to give me the history behind that junior.
Trip to London, and when him go over there, Young, Gifted and Black was already established, big, big tune in England. So he came back telling me that. So even when I started to tour with Bob, I remember some of the places I went in England, and Bonham was there and some other stars, and I was saying to Bob, if him know that him have a superstar backing him up, you know, so those are the things. I didn't feel, I was already out there, you know, with some international exposure. So I was feeling honored to be with Bob because I knew that this man was special. Mm. I gave him flowers while he was there. Him didn't have to pass on me to know who he was because I saw some unique things come out of this man that up until this day, I don't see another one. So I was really happy to be with him, and his Bob opened my eyes that I started realizing that music was not just entertainment and fun, it went much deeper. When I saw how serious this man took his music, that is what opened my eyes, and I realized that the music is a serious thing, it's a responsibility that you have, because here you are, one person sending messages to the four corners of the earth. And these messages going to everyone, touching souls, teaching and uplifting. And I realize that it is very important that the message you send to people, to the world, is a serious thing. And it depends, it is on your shoulder, and it depends on the message you are sending there, whether it's going to divide or unite. So I am thankful for him that he opened my eyes. I started thinking about the lyrics and the message that I'm going to send to people because of how serious I saw this man take his music.
All right, I'll take you forward into Italy. Bob Marley and the Waliers, 100,000 people in front of you. More than the Pope could have ever tried in his own place. Oh, you
never forget that. Well, the Pope thing, it flopped, you know.
Yeah, well, that's what I said. Come flop the Pope in Italy.
That was the headline in the paper.
Yeah, what's the headline, too?
Yeah.
What's the headline, yeah. That's a serious thing, you know. See? Bob Marley go Italy, go flop the Pope. So, well, I mean, you know, in the changing room, and you know, talk about this concert, you know, 100,000 people out there and think. What would I say to myself? Like, you are written.
Well, I was really, really shocked.
Yeah.
Because I never know the power that this man had until I witnessed, you know, that the Pope, nobody attended.
Without a opening act. That's what was told. It's true that?
Not at that time. Eventually.
We're not talking about IGs, man. We're talking about another act, like we didn't have the Commodores. And
yes.
We never have an opening act, per se.
No.
Bob Marley and the Waliers.
Just Bob Marley and the Waliers.
100,000 people in front of him, right in Italy.
Yes.
Where the Pope there.
Yes.
And the Pope couldn't draw the crowd there. When you're not in the changing room, won't attack, say.
Well, Neville Garrick and himself was in there, and it was just amazement because other people, Italians, came in the dressing room talking about it with us.
Yes.
And said, I've never seen anything like this. This never happened in history.
A Jamaican artist come to that.
Yes, one man.
That is a good feeling.
It was kind of a little fearful because you don't know what.
Room you're there.
Yes.
Yeah, you come lick down the Pope right there in the backyard. You're gonna retaliate.
Boy, that was really, really an experience.
Tell me next concert where sticking out your mind parallel with Waliers.
Switzerland. Mm. I walked out. This is before Italy, I think. Walk out on stage here, and it's the first time we're going to witness 80,000 people. Because we started out with 500 people, you know, and every year it grew.
Yes.
We just watch it, the multitude of people start just coming in from all over the world. When I walked out there, like about in the front.
This is in Zurich, which part?
Sweden.
Switzerland. Switzerland.
One of them. Tivoli Garden. I think it was Tivoli Garden.
Oh.
When we walk out there, we see this multitude of people, and in the front was like about 20,000 paraplegics in wheelchair.
Mm-hmm.
But them placed them right in the front. I was so shocked. The first thing that came to my mind, I said, Father, I am just praying that if it's even one out of the multitude going to receive the message today, no matter what. Then I realized now that these people, them can't, that some of them don't even understand the language, but them know that the music has a positive vibration.
So now they never get up.
Boy, it's only that leaf in
the middle. Ball out the bowl.
No, but I see you, Muta, believe me, when you see them parapets, they clap and start.
Yes,
it's
yes.
Like they want to get up out of that chair.
The power.
The music, just the power of the music.
Mm-hmm.
And that is when I realized what was going on. When I saw all these people and this paraplegic in the front, that is a moment that I never leave my mind. And Italy with the Pope, when Bob flapped.
The Pope. All right. We want to mention the name, because we know it says I tree and not I trees.
Yes, it's like
some people say I trees because they want to pluralize, choose three persons.
It's like saying we three.
Yeah.
And I'm the person who named that group.
I tree.
Yes. But
give me the tell me this shot the name of that. No, I don't have to feel the way to say that you name it, so nobody can come touch you.
We wanted a different name. Mm. And I was doing some shows at Osa Chen.
Mm-hmm.
And as Judy always say, it was like a mystery. Oh, Mr. Dad invite us individually to come in the studio to do some harmonies and some songs at Studio One. And that's how all three of us met up there. But Rita and myself, we were coming from way back before we met Sister Judy.
Yeah.
And when I saw them, I said, you know, I would like to invite the sisters to come and do some harmonies, because I have three shows at Osa Chen, and they were so happy. We do a little quick rehearsal and them come, and show was nice. The third night now, we decided to just do a jam session on stage, sweet inspiration song, and the audience loved it and said, why you good girls don't form a group? And we say, why not? You know, because we sounded so good, and sweet inspiration was a popular group in Jamaica at the time.
I can't just say you're gonna get influenced by that.
Yes.
The harmony wanna carry.
Definitely.
It's like how Williams get influenced by the impressions.
Curtis Mayfield and impressions. And Muta, would you believe it, that at that particular time was the time when Peter, Bonnie and Bob, they were having some differences. I didn't know what it was.
Mm-hmm.
But when the group was formed, I3, I said, let's call ourselves I3. And Rita said, I3. Said, yes. Like saying, we three. So they understood what that meant.
Yeah.
And right at that point when that followed was when Bob heard that we form a group.
Because
we went to arena and did a gospel show.
Yeah.
And him started to hear that, you know, we have a group going. And him just invite us in to do Natty Dread.
Yeah. And that was it.
The rest is history. But prior to that, Rita and myself did Rocket Baby, just the two of us with Bob. And we went in and do Natty Dread, then we did Jalive. And everything just, you know, we ended up doing the entire Natty Dread album, and we started touring right there.
So as a group become popular, and you realize it's three man did a function at the group up front, and knowing say right now it's almost like on a replace two of the man them. On never see that a replacement.
I saw it that it is ordained.
Mm.
And up until this day, no one can tell me says any other way.
Mm.
It was ordained by the Almighty that we ended up being these three little birds. And everything was just, it was just like green light all the way. And everyone found their, you know, started doing their solo.
Yes.
Bonnie, Peter, and everything. But, you know, it was a success.
You know, it's amazing. Bonnie, Peter, and Bob find them niche as individuals, and then Marcia, Judy, and Rita find them niche in them own way. It's like, wow, out of the same collective,
yes, from
individuals.
But I started out as a solo singer, and I never
really
that.
We know that. We're going to come forward. This is the cutting edge, and I refer.
This is the team from Augustown. This is what I say. Marcia Griffiths, big up yourself. You set the trend for many of us. You're definitely a trailblazer, and we wish for you many, many, many more successful years in the business. As per usual, enough love, musical love. See you young as you are.
This is not a USA. Iriefm.
Yes, we're talking to Sister Marcia Griffiths here, and may I tell you, this is a marathon interview, don't it?
Yes. It's a marathon. For real.
Not only am I able to listen to Mutabaruka tonight, but also there is a live stream broadcast with Marcia Griffiths. Wow, this is such a special treat. Gone again. Sure. I want the man, Rasta. The man that earned so much money and can't get a good Galaxy S4. Okay. Wow. This is such a special treat. And my heart and soul needed this tonight. Marcia celebrating 50 years in the music industry. Special woman. Such talent.
Oh, give thanks.
That are coming from Germany.
Yes.
All right.
And thank you for watching and listening. As you said, not only listening, but...
A woman anthem. Woman does love that tune. I don't care if them have chicky be them get up and dance. Believe you me, it's a sweet song. Who write that song there?
Jackie Edwards.
Eh?
Yeah.
The late great Jackie Edwards. Wow. Sweet song, man. Okay. You know, so you have some people that say, you don't know that tune with Bob and the Dover. With Marcia Griffiths.
True.
I see what you know.
Yeah.
You know, say. Bob and the Dover, one tune with Marcia Griffiths singing him Fire Burning. I don't know say Bob and the tune from them time.
No.
They ask Michelle, I don't want to stop asking. Believe you me. Say Michelle. See there? All right. Michelle. Girl. Yeah.
Do you realize that the rhythm track is also a Bob and the song?
Yeah.
Feeling soul.
Feeling that. Just be true to one.
Yes.
So it's a nice question. Where do you use the rhythm and the words of Bob and fuse it again?
We had the rhythm.
It's true. Bob and the song. Bob and the song.
That me say. Fire burning tune and feeling soul.
Yeah.
The rhythm to feeling soul and the words to burning.
Exactly.
But we had the rhythm feeling soul. And when Marcia came at night, she just started singing this song.
I said, what did it fit perfectly?
Yeah.
Yeah,
we said, well, come run with it, man.
Watch out, you bully it, man. You know, you're not going to stop you, you know.
She has a song coming up named I'm Not a Superwoman.
Yeah. Oh, that tune from like, the
original song.
Original.
Oh, the original Superwoman?
Yes. Okay. This one. Next year.
So when you release that?
Well, January, February. Next year.
Well, like, well, you have so much tune with her and now release them, you know, that's that. What you deal with?
It keeps her. You want more?
Yeah. Oh, you mean, man?
All right, that's what you have to do it.
A penthouse in here, you know? You're there, we up, me so, you know? We up at the top floor, you know? No, but wait, you know? Marcia Griffiths, you have, you know, may I tell you, sir, you have woolly more than you, you know? Believe you me.
If she would have come to the studio.
She would come at the studio, man.
Where much is given, much is required.
Yeah.
Yes, and I ask God to preserve me so I can continue to feed souls and touch souls to the medium of music. So I shall sing as long as I live.
And you know, say all of the youth them know you too. You're one of the only female singers, and I say non-apologetically, from the age of Rocksteady, where if you ask a youth out there know where I dance or Bounty Killer, them say Marcia Griffiths, oh yeah. I used to, when you're the past stage, trust me.
Well, that is the reason why I can't do dancehall show. But you know, one of my...
You don't want to clash with somebody past stage.
No.
We can't get somebody, the angel. We don't want to clash with the angel. Don't ever want to past stage again. But you could have clashed with the angel, you know.
No, me never come for that. You know, one of my greatest moments on this journey was a show that Copeland... had gotten from me, where name Yamins and Jamins. Oh, yeah, yeah. Down at Mobi. Muta, I never know what kind of thing it was. And when I walk into this place, I see about 80,000 little babies. Believe me, I'm seeing me and I said, look here, I am going back to the hotel and not doing this show.
I get jumpy, you get nervous.
No, I said, this is, not my audience. Why you book me on a show like this? Because this is, me mean like 3-year-old and 5-year-old, you know, and 6. Me don't know if anything in the past 10. Honestly, this was something for those babies. And I said to him, I am not doing it. And I was just quarreling. By the time I was here quarreling, them was introducing me.
Yeah.
So I just take brave heart and just walk on the stage. And then I thought some distraction was going on there, but it was not distraction.
It was you, them are real fun.
Muta, when I go up there, I could do no wrong.
Yes.
All the media that was there was just asking me one question, what it feels like to cross over to the youth, this audience.
When me, I tell you, say,
I would never forget that moment. I mean, little babies have all them little napkin in a long line waiting to come and get autograph. You see all of them touch electric slide?
Oh, gosh, man. And you can't, and the same thing in a party too, you know. Same thing in a party too. You play Marcia Griffiths. It's not like an oldies you play.
That moment put the icing on the cake for my journey.
Yes. Let me indelible mark in a Marcia Griffiths.
All right, that was a moment that I can never forget. Because Judy and herself, we refuse. We never go in with everybody now. We say we're not going. And as they, after Bob and Rita and the musicians left, we come together and we decide that we'll go and them send a ticket because Bob wasn't too pleased that we weren't coming. So I was so happy to see us. I lose all my little toenail on the journey. But
you never look fit.
Yeah, if I find it, I'll put it back. Yeah, man, we put it back inside of the show. But Muta on stage that night, we were doing Lively Up Yourself, and then I think we cut down to No Man Cry. So me smell something very strange, and we look around, and the Prince did just drive in. And of course, it was Mugabe swearing. And I look around to see if anybody else smell what I smell, because something just strange and my eyes start burning. By the time I realized, everybody was, it was a stampede. I saw some kids being trampled.
This is a picture of them man, with all the thing cave in.
Oh, God.
People didn't drop off.
Muta, we were with Joe Stablisky, and he born and grew up in a Rhodesia. And from as a little girl, I hear my grandparents used to talk about Rhodesia and it's nothing but war. And when we start to run with everybody else and everybody being trampled. But everybody running for them life. And we never leave Joe because we say, well, since him come from them, him we know. But when we look, we see pure war tankers with soldiers. So we say, Rattity, because them have so much black people one place. Them just decide, so them going to kill off everybody.
Are you in a big like that?
I mean, in the middle of it, I run, all three of us are run. We run, and then when I see the war tankers and everybody geared for war, and I say, well, this is it. Me look to the heavens and I say, Father, me this is a Rhodesia, come take me life. We in a Rhodesia, I'm a fear all this time. And we never stop running until we reach the house where we were staying. And we feel safe. And then Jono was a man who make we never stop running because him start to tremble and say he never see this in him life.
And him lived over there.
And him lived there. You see, when we reach the house, we start to worry about Bob and Ziggy because Ziggy was a little baby. And Rita would say, brought it warm to Bob, man. And the musicians, Muta. Me respect the man from that night.
You still up on the stage.
The man, I don't know how he protects Ziggy. I'll know whenever I'm going to find out. But after everything, you know, Bob went back on stage and finished him in performance. And then when he reached the house, and see the throwaway in the house. He just looked at me and said, now we know who are the real revolutionary. We feel so bad.
Yes, yes.
I couldn't even ask him how it goes.
After I've done that to you.
Yeah. Can we run, leave him?
Yeah. You get your key again?
QE.
Eh? All right. Stop all of herself now. Shakimbo. Give her one of those albums. It's the first to say album. You never know to them thing have music for it. You didn't know? Alright. They call it long playing album. It's not something we pull up a picture in either. It's something we play music. Alright. Okay. You know, so we're upon the closing hours of this program, and so we give thanks to all the people who take part in them. Because if I can't find the name them again, believe you me, them give me some enough paper here, so you know, all right?
So, German, one is Cuban and one is Marco.
Let's work it out. All right. Michelle Scott, she gone home. She tell me say she work hard upon this program, and so she couldn't stay up. Lie she tell. Okay. Michelle Scott, Mark. The magician over there, so computer maverick, believe you me, anything where you want, the computer, just come to me and we refer you to him. Probably have to get my 10% too. Monique from Portland. Remember everything you tell me, a pig saying you got school. You never tell me that. It's a pig farming saying you go have school, pork. So you can't stop eating pork because pork said you got school. You know, I've said that parade. I've said it already. Abu, Romeo, where Romeo them gone to bed? You mean at the studio with Brian? Okay. Cuban they behind the console because crack gone. Copeland Fabs sitting over there, so a coach Marcia the whole night. Like said, she's on over she had said. Okay. Donovan Jermaine.
One for Marie, one for Jackie.
Okay, one for Marie, one for Jackie. All right, Jermaine, the producer of this album, and all we are giving free one. Make sure everyone get one who take part in this thing. Yeah. We don't say Cabo name on this paper, yeah, but we want you sign one for Cabo too, because she's the one who make this thing work. And the CEO, we want she to get one too. DJ Brian. Yeah, the little youth over there, so we always look upon alkaline body. Him not stop look upon alkaline body, you know.
Kaboom, hurry!
You see
them little fool there, try copy them fish, pop it!
The man love, hey, the man love, what them call it? What them call the thing with them put on them skin? That, hey, believe you me, man, me and the man sit down there for all 4 hours, you know. And them there for the computer, you know. Him have a double screen, you know, alkaline vibes cartel. And him just a look for him, so. May I tell you? But we love him. We love you, brethren. May your brethren. Yeah, DJ Brian. Mr. Wisdom, well, him gone now, I crack him name. Jackie, responsible for the decoration, the design in here. Bridget Anderson, who come with Marcia, I assume, I presume. It's true? Is she come with you? She come with you, okay.
She accompany, I fixed it up.
She accompany, okay. Marie came also, and Takura also, and the what's your name again? What's your name again, Mama? Operator? Monique, stop the secret talk on this. I remember her name. What's your name again? Shamara, believe you me, it's from them days, from the other day, I don't see you, but me really, me go home and feel it for you, you know. You get over it yet? You don't get over it yet? You still are? All right. Sorry again about that. Anyway. Okay.
Muta, I want to big up my driver who took me here, Donovan.
Donovan Jeremy.
Donovan.
Him turn driver.
No, shot, man. Him outside. Him show coming.
Things now go out, people. Again, him have to turn your driver, though. Hey! Why?
Donovan outside, man.
I don't know. You have some man with a billionaire, you know. When you look at them car key clothes, I go to them farm, you know, it's a joke. You would believe them. Yeah, that of how you drive outside. Don't ever come in.
Well,
sign a record for him, man. Sign a record for him. Donovan. Who else you want big up? Who else you want big up? Uncle Donovan.
You mean who is here?
Anybody who not there. I mean.
No, you know. I want big up the whole of Jamaica and my family. Because them past fans, no, you know, it's family.
Yes.
Because God has preserved me, but them support me over the years.
Yes.
Because, you know, sometimes you just want to give it up, but your fans just always...
No, you're not going to give it up, man. Are you alive?
No,
you're
not give it up.
Yeah. You sing as long as you live.
When my fans happy, me happy.
Yes,
am here for them. So I just want to big them up. All of Jamaica. Every part of Jamaica. And the world... Who is watching us right now?
What the last tour, you know? The last tour, tour. States, from state to country to country.
Barry Salmon and myself.
You and Barry Salmon got tour together. Yeah. How much state, how much place, you know?
Well, like 6-7 weeks out there.
You know, the bus.
West Coast and East Coast. Bus, lovely. Beautiful.
You still, you don't feel no pressure. I mean, after years of riding on a bus with some big bossy tone man and all them something, you don't feel like until you stop though. I mean,
no.
One of the sweetest part of tour is on the bus.
Yes.
The bus.
And the whole part of the tour, we love it. Yes. Every part of it.
And then, what is the next tour lineup?
But you know, I see a whole lot of young artists out there who can't manage 2 weeks, you know.
You're serious?
It's like, Copeland, you know. Because them start to complain. I said, boy,
the bus drive too long and the hotel business and mafia move from one hotel
every
to the next.
Every day you move from one place to another.
Bring the wine, look, Bridget. Take it out of the bag there and bring it now, man. No, you're going like you want to hold up on the wine. So try you go buy it. No, just bring the put out the bag, man. Yes. Marcia Griffiths asked for wine the whole night. Marcia Griffiths asked for wine the whole night. I mean, Marcia Griffiths.
Yeah, Mota. Oh, God. You know, my sister Tanya Stevens was supposed to be here too, you know.
So why is she not here?
I don't know. Maybe some.
Beautiful sister that.
Yes. And I want big up all Queen Africa and, you know, all of the female singers.
All right, you want to drink this now or you want to drink it when you're driving?
No, I don't drink and drive.
Donovan German, Donovan outside that drive, you know. I don't think you really want. All right, so you want to drink it now?
No, I mean, everyone would partake in that is here. We have quite
you know, see a little bit of them. Them not for drink wine. No, she said she want to drink it now. She not drink and drive. All right. Virgin, bust this wine and cup and glass and make sure she share up this thing.
Yeah, everyone can.
Argentina. Have a Argentina, right?
And I'm a big drinker in a motor. So
no, I don't nothing. I don't nothing.
Occasionally, I have some red wine.
Yes, and now it's occasion for red wine. So, where
I'm having cake.
Where the cake there? Where the rest of the cake there? Hey, what do you think? Hey,
I
left the cake for Iriefm work and tomorrow. You know, carry the cake.
Hello.
Make you carry it to him.
I never see a cake disappear so far.
Wait, man.
So fast.
On a not making the cake stay for the workers tomorrow. Give her the cake, make she carry go home. If she carry go to Florida tomorrow. Go you go tomorrow? Yes, she go to Florida. Wrap the cake and give her, make she carry it to home. You know, so they have planned for it for lunch tomorrow. They have planned for the cake for lunch tomorrow. It's Marcia Griffiths, the cake, right? Marcia Griffiths, not Iriefm staff. Give her the cake, make she carry it to home. Okay, so... All right. It was wonderful. Really wonderful. Believe you me. It was, I enjoyed it.
And you know, Mota has so much things to say, but the time is always so short. So much.
Why artists always say that? But the time, so much things to say, but the time always short.
Well, if you do the journey, you know, as long as me, you know, is that.
You have some 50 years, can't pack it up 4 hours.
No.
All right. So, see, the next 50 years, we'll call you back.
Yes, we're ready. Yeah. We're
when
ready.
You celebrate the next 50 years of the music, we're going to call you back. Right? Yeah. Promise me, man. You know, I promise me.
Oh, you mean I tell her that I'll be ready?
All right.
Yes.
So, next 50 years, we'll come right forward, right?
That's next 50 years strong. We're ready.
Yes, yeah, man. Jeremy, you're a good producer.
Thank you.
Believe you me, I like the part where you take now. As me, I say, every time I see a Penthouse email, download immediately.
Thank you.
I mean, I say, it's a little sister named Sugar. Gone.
Mm.
Gone. Sugar. Clear, clear, clear. Yes. Copeland. The man who been there and done that. And done even more than that. Why you're not experiencing your own self? Afraid to make you talk at all, because you could have walked the whole hour for talk. I'm afraid to make you talk. But it's 20 minutes. But come over here, sir. Come over here, sir. Remember, please, don't care about the tiles at the moment. You flush the tile in. I don't have the tiled paper and all them things. Don't start straight now. Marcia Griffiths, as a man who been there, done that. Marcia Griffiths, tell me.
Well, Marcia, it goes without saying that she's just one of the greatest female singers ever to come out of Jamaica and to even out of the idiom of reggae music. You know, I'm honored, as I said before, to be a part of this musical journey of 50 years, you know, because when you really look back, you know, and sitting here all night and you were going through all the history, some of them I started to replay in my head, and it wasn't easy then, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It was much hard, but as the saying goes, those days, it was just the love of the music, you know, it wasn't about the money.
Yeah.
You know, the love, and it's the love that brought it all here that even the young ones can enjoy.
I know, if it was the money, shouldn't they, so right now? No, if it was the money, should I do it for shouldn't they, right now, you know?
Yes, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. It was
because, you
see,
when you can't get money, you get frustrated.
The money was never there.
Yes, and that's how you don't get frustrated, no, and nobody with it.
But I must say that she has played such a great role, and, you know, internationally, you know, even when the Electric Boogie whole thing started, you know, it was like those days we were doing 12-week tour, you know,
mm-hmm.
with the Reggae Sun Splash tour, not yeah. 2 weeks a year, some man, 2 weeks and come back.
Yeah.
12 weeks, 15 weeks running from Japan Splash over into the US
yes.
and continue, you know, going along. And one thing I must say, and I don't think any other female have this record, she toured for 12 weeks and she never repeat one outfit.
Yeah.
Seriously. She never repeat one outfit.
I can't believe that.
You know? The only thing she will say, if she's going to perform in a city and she's not, she will say, the last time I was here was when, I would say like 2 years ago, what did I wear?
Yes. You know? And you have to remember that?
Yeah, you try.
That's serious brain.
You know? But if she knows that she wears, say, a black and yellow, the last time here, even though it's 2 years ago, she's going to wear something else.
Black and blue.
You know, and I remember one night at the Greek Theater, you know, she wore an outfit with a hat that flips up and down.
Yeah.
And a nice outfit. And when she started Electric Boogie, people start jumping on stage. They had about 500
Lord
people on stage.
Have mercy.
Eh?
Yeah, Zola was going.
But we know they say you always lead the Electric Boogie slide all over the place. They tell me, you're like, are you a lead it?
Well, I am honored.
I
was there
the
in
them.
The studio when it was recorded. As a matter of fact, I was auditioned to do that. Didn't miss Kelly with the Electric Belly?
You mean the one who passed the Bonneville, I don't?
Yeah, they were trying to do that. And I was
nobody
that
was able to do it.
Nobody couldn't do it.
Eh?
Yeah, we tried about six of us.
Okay.
My trial was about 3 a.m, you know what I mean, when they called me in the studio. We have it on tape. If you ever see it, laugh till a week.
Okay.
And then the producer just said, Marcia, come here. We were wondering what he was going to do. He said, okay, we're going to do a speed rap. And he just said, they got Mr. Kelly with the bubbling electric belly. She's a moving along with electric. She sure got the boogie.
Yes.
You know, and she like one take and got it done.
You couldn't take Bob Marley, Bob Bonneville as peers.
No, quite about six people tried it tonight and couldn't work.
No, man, let me tell you, Bonnie's a one in the world, man.
Seriously. You know? All right, sir. All right, we have two more. Bridget, Brian, play that two there for me.
All right, give thanks. This is Lot and Fire. And you know we have to give thanks to the elders, them who set the thing. And also Sister Marcia Griffiths, my mother in the music, a lady who always see me and give me the best of encouragement, always tell me, say, Lot and Fire, you're a gem, just go and do your thing. We say enough respect and manners for your 50th anniversary in this music business. Give thanks, Lot and Fire. Big up Mama Marcia Griffiths.
You're on the wrong side of the fence. Big up to my musical mother, you know what I'm saying? And congratulations, you know what I'm saying? D-Major representing for the one and only Marcia Griffith. One of my biggest influences, keep the music clean, you know, good lyrics, everything. And we just wish you all the best and continued success. You see, my mommy, D-Major said that real, no real, every time. Major.
No plan.
Just giving God thanks to see that day when it comes.
Okay.
Yeah. No plans.
It's beautiful that you can reach a certain age and still in the light and the minds of the people them. And I guess a lot of people who do things would hope for a remembrance of such magnitude in them life where you do a work and you're still alive and people say, yes, you do it well. You know, and it's a goal where most ones who reach there never really force themselves to reach there, but because of them work, them light just shine and glow in front of everyone that it become the light of other people too.
Yes.
So when we recognize the greatness of people, especially for the music and for the soul that govern that music, we have to really give thanks for that soul.
Can you imagine?
So we don't know if Jackie want to raise a toast.
Yes, Jackie.
We can hold up this glass.
I am truly thankful.
Monique, don't stop fighting over there. So we can hold a toast for Marcia. So just hold up the glass if you're not drinking.
Come in, Donovan, German.
Jackie, you have to hold that toast. You have to come over here, so you have to come over here, so man. Get Jackie that mic there. Copeland or whosoever.
Yes, my sister.
Yes, Marcia. Well,
We have to hold that toast. Wait, hold on. We can't leave out. What's your name, not at this toast? We could just hold the toast. Whether you drink the thing or not, hold the toast. Okay. All right, more people are come. They hear it from outside now, they might take part in the toast. The toast, and make a toast.
More life.
All right, so Jackie, I'm going to get the toast.
Well, Marcia, you know, we drink too.
Wait, hold on. Go behind the thing now, come through, man. Don't flap me, you know. All right. You have to talk in a little
time. Marcia? All the best, my love. It was really nice tonight. And we now have to take a drink for your continued health, wealth, and lots more success.
Oh, thank you, my sister. Ventures. Health.
Wealth. Success.
Health is wealth.
Yes, that's right.
That's first and the greatest.
Yes.
Endorse.
Give thanks.
One good thing about music, when it hits you, feel no pain. Whoa, I say, music, when it hits you feel no pain. So hit me with music, yeah. Hit me with music now. This is Trench Town Rock. I say don't watch that. Trench Town Rock. If you are big fish or trout now, you reap what you sow. Trench Town Rock. And only Jaja knows. Trench Town Rock. I'll never turn my back. Trench Town Rock. I give the slum a try. Trench Town Rock. I never let the children cry. You got to tell Jaja why. It's Kingston 12 now. It's Kingston 12. Oh, it's Kingston 12. It's Kingston 12.
Why you think I love so? Why you think I love so?
Scabadistab.
Won't come cooler.
Scabadabadistab.
Can't come cooler.
Whoa, I'm a grooving. And the world knows when it hits you,
that's a big, 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 big tune. You know, I will if I did not know that tune.
Muta, believe me, some people think it's the best song that I've ever done.
You see,
including
right?
My son.
Your son thinks it's the best song, you
yes.
know?
Yes.
I did not get none of earplay, though.
No earplay, none whatsoever.
Yeah, but we play it, though, believe you.
Silly Walks, produced by Silly Walks.
So you're watching now. We give thanks to the moment, give thanks to the time and the energy. Give thanks to Marcia Griffiths for come through and celebrate. And give thanks to all the ones them who take part in this celebration. Understand? And we really big up Iriefm for really do this. You know what I mean?
For really, and truly. Like dust that motor.
Yeah, we give thanks that Iriefm
yes,
could do this.
Thanks you know? To Iriefm and motor. Not to mention you, my brother.
Yeah, man, give thanks. So,
the thought that, you know, for you to even conceive the thought to do it.
Yes,
I'm
yes.
truly thankful.
So, we have a date 50 years from now.
Yes.
For the next interview.
Yes.
100th anniversary of Marcia Griffiths.
Yeah.
And Matrix are lining up himself, you know. Matrix lining up himself. Brian, you don't sleep tonight at all. I see y'all dancing at the place. Oh, God, man. And the first I see Brian move, so. The first from Brian there with me, I see him move, so. And he's the youngest one in the house, yeah. The
really?
Engineer, see him over there, so. Yeah, man, see him over there, so, man.
A little. Wait there, oh.
Yeah, him there through the glasses, yeah. So. Not Mark,
no.
Mark. Not Mark, Brian.
Oh,
see
Brian.
See him wave to you,
yeah.
There, him wave to you, yeah.